Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to place your MVS cartridges that have these. Sometimes you'll order them or buy them and they come with these really generic looking labels on top. And the reason why this happens is a lot of resellers didn't want the serial numbers on their cartridges. So yeah, when they sold them, you know, I guess you could say they couldn't be tracked. But other than that, there are some times where people will reuse old cartridges like this one here. This actually used to be a King of Fighters, and to save or put a cartridge in a better cart, they'll do a swap or whatever for a better game, or from a dead cart, you know, they'll put a game in there or what. So yeah, this here, it's actually pretty easy. Basically, they're already made, you just gotta print them out. And I have the website here. This is at JammaNationX.com, and they have all the labels there. Instead of having the serial numbers, you'll notice that they have the actual the number for the title, but they have everything on there pretty much for the most part. I think everything is on there if I'm not mistaken, but yeah, you could go down there. Some of these games that aren't even legit titles are on there too. But yeah, I'll put a link in the description. So here I have my last play cart. It was actually really weird because, spread a little WD-40 on there. The label I removed on there, it was one of these guys here, like similar to Artifying. You've probably seen those before, but when I unpeeled it, there was actually a King of Fighters logo on there. You see, yeah, the WD-40 works pretty well. Actually works better than the alcohol, but yeah, see there. And then you just want to wipe it off and make sure that it's completely gone. You don't want any extra residue on there. And when you place the WD-40, I mean, you don't even need a whole lot. You just need like a light spray, and nothing to oversaturate the cloth or whatever. Yeah, see, we have it pretty much in good shape here. Another thing I like to do with these, because sometimes they are, if you notice, they're fairly dusty. At first, these Q-tips will not fit, but if you press them down, they will actually form, I guess you could say, they'll form to where they could actually fit through. And I'm not sure if you can see that compared to the pleat above it, but it's actually a lot cleaner. But yeah, we'll go ahead and do all that. And yeah, I mean, you can clean it out fairly well doing this method. Of course, there's other ways you can do it, but yeah, this is what I usually do when I'm cleaning these MVS games here. You know, if you're gonna replace the label, make it look a little bit nicer, you might as well do these other ones as well, you know, little cleaning methods or what. And of course, these here can get dirty, and you can do a light swab of, well, I usually use like alcohol or whatever, you know, similar to an NES cart, but again, not a lot. And if you get a blue screen when you put these MVS carts, like say in your neo-geo or whatever, and it does like a, I guess you could say like a RAM check, sometimes that could be because the contacts are dirty. I've had it where I've had the game pop up with a blue screen, and then it shows all the chips, and the, you know, sometimes it shows that they're there and sometimes it doesn't detect them. But after a good cleaning, I would actually get it running again. So yeah, just little tidbits. But yeah, if you own MVS cards, you probably already know that. Yeah, not too shabby. Got a couple more here, but yeah, of course you could also open up the cart. If it's fairly dusty like this, most likely it's gonna be pretty dusty inside as well. So you have the four screws here, And you could also get to cleaning the inside, but I don't recommend, like, you know, actually using like cloths or whatever. Some compressed air would probably be a little bit better to clean the boards as opposed to like wiping them down. But yeah, that's basically the concept here. Let's go ahead and put on this label for you guys. So after you print them out, all you have to do is cut them up and you'll be good to go. Use regular paper for this, but if you notice, the actual MVS games, they have a little bit of gloss to them, so it's at your preference. Of course, I guess how much of a perfectionist you are, whether or not you want to use like something a little bit more matted or glossed. But of course, regardless of what you use, it's going to look a lot better than the generic labels that had come with these some of these cartridges. One thing I want to note is if you have a MVS cartridge that is a US version and you know for a fact that it is a US version, I may not recommend you making a label, especially if you could tell that it is actually a US version, because sometimes people will value a US cartridge over a Japanese cartridge just because of the, I guess they weren't as common. So be cautious about that, because sometimes you could get your cartridge could be worth more if it's a US version. And the only way that you can prove that it is a US version as opposed to a Japanese version is if it has the official label, serial numbers, and so forth. So do take precaution if you do make labels for US, like if you know definitely it's a US cartridge, because that's the only difference, or the only way you could determine the difference between a US cartridge and a Japanese cartridge. So always keep that in mind when deciding on doing MVS labels for your games. Yeah, I have them all cut up, and now let's go ahead and do a quick application here. This is quite similar to how I would do them for the NES cartridges. What I'm using here is nothing too spectacular. But it's not regular glue. I guess you could use regular glue, but this is silicone RTV. Basically, it's an adhesive, and all you really need is a really light coat. And before you want to place them in, let me show you here, just in case you already got your MVS cartridges out, the label off already. But you want the label facing where you can read it from the direction of the arrow pointing towards you. So if the arrow is pointing towards you, you should be able to read the label, not the other way around. So keep that in mind also when you're applying this. But let's go ahead and get a label on this guy here. Have it facing towards us. In other words, the screws will be facing away from you. Zoom out here a little bit. And this one here will be last blade. I have a couple of cards here. I'm doing them one at a time so I don't forget which card is what. But, I just get a little bit of silicone here. I guess you could use a cotton swab or whatever. But, let's get some of this off here. A little dry excess, but you don't need a whole lot because this is on a flat surface, so it adheres fairly well. But just want to put like a really light coat on there. You don't want nothing that is, I guess you could say, that distinguishable. You just want a super light coat. And there you go. Then you get your label. Of course, again, facing your direction. And just press it on there, and you're good to go. make sure it's completely flat. And with this type of material, the silicone RTV, it may feel like it moves around a little bit, but you give it an hour and it'll set just fine. And just to compare it with, a legit cart. There you go. Now some of these guys, if you notice, have like a holographic reflection to there. I can't help you there, but yeah, that's basically how you would get these guys on there. I print out dimensions and so forth. I like to thank Jamma Nation X for actually taking the time to make all these labels, because they do come in handy. But yeah, I thought it'd be cool to share since I have a couple of carts that I need to replace. So that's basically how you print them out and stick them on. Thanks again for watching. This is Agent Zero for Yakuza Games, and I'll talk to you guys next time.